MCQs based on American literature. Post-independence American literature. Questions based on works of Washington Irving, James Fenimore Cooper, Edgar Allan Poe, Ralph Waldo Emerson, H.D. Thoreau, Hawthorne, and Melville. Hello and welcome to the discourse. Let us revise the post-independence American literature. The mode of revision will be a series of multiple choice questions based on the course of UGC NET English Literature. So let us begin with the first question. Herman Melville wrote Typee and Omu on the basis of his experiences of option A, sea, option B, city life, option C, forest life, and option D, family life. The correct choice is A. Typee and Omu was based on the sea life experiences of Herman Melville. Question number 2 is, for whom was the sea a rich source of metaphor? Option A, Herman Melville, option B, Henry James, option C, H.D. Thoreau, and option D, R.W. Emerson. The right answer is A, Herman Melville. For Herman Melville, the sea was a rich source of metaphor. Question number 3 is, on which work does Melville castigate white civilization? Option A, Omu, option B, Typee, option C, Mardi, and option D, Moby Dick. The right choice is B. For Typee, Melville castigates white civilization. Question number 4 is, in Omu, Melville takes up the narrative where he left it in option A, Omu, option B, Typee, option C, Mardi, and option D, Moby Dick. The correct answer is B. Typee was a prequel to Omu. Question number 5 is, Melville's which book is interesting to be studied as a preliminary to his Moby Dick? Option A, Typee, option B, Omu, option C, Mardi, and option D, White Jacket. The correct choice is C. Mardi is the book in which Melville discussed the philosophical aspects of Moby Dick. Question number 6 is, there are traces of Charles Dickens in Herman Melville's option A, Moby Dick, option B, Bartleby the Scrivener, option C, Typee, and option D, Mardi. The right choice is B. In Bartleby the Scrivener. Question number 7 is, in which work does Melville leave the sea and far off places to write in the third person? Option A, Pierre, option B, Moby Dick, option C, Mardi, and option D, Typee. The right choice is A, Pierre, in which Herman Melville tells the story of Pierre Glendinning Jr. in third person. Question number 8 is, which book of Melville reflects Shakespearean soliloquies? Option A, Omu, option B, Typee, option C, Moby Dick, and option D, Pierre. The right answer is C. Moby Dick's protagonist, Captain Ahab, appears to be inspired by Shakespearean characters such as Hamlet, Macbeth, and King Lear. Question number 9 is, emblem, symbol, moral, analogy, type, images are the favorite words of option A, Emerson, option B, Thoreau, option C, Melville, and option D, Hawthorne. The correct choice is D. Nathaniel Hawthorne used these words and concepts in his works again and again. As for example, in the case of The Scarlet Letter. Question number 10 is, Hawthorne's observations are usually of man in option A, society, option B, nature, option C, variance with nature, and option D, woods. The correct answer is A, society. Nathaniel Hawthorne often wrote about societal behavior and complications of man. Question number 11 is, Nathaniel Hawthorne is a writer of option A, prose, option B, fiction, Option C, plays, and option D, drama. The right choice is B. Nathaniel Hawthorne is a writer of fiction. Question number 12 is, Wu, regarding Hawthorne, posed this question, could he have been more self-assured? Option A, Jack London. Option B, Henry James. Option C, Stephen Foster. And option D, Mark Twain. The correct choice is B. Henry James posed this question, could he have been more self-assured while praising Nathaniel Hawthorne? Question number 13 is, who called Nathaniel Hawthorne a harmless Hawthorne? Option A, R.W. Emerson. Option B, H.D. Thoreau. Option C, Herman Melville. And option D, Edgar Allan Poe. The right answer is C. Herman Melville called Nathaniel Hawthorne as harmless Hawthorne while praising him in 1850. Question number 14 is, Thoreau's poems are as Emerson's, option A, poetical, option B, satirical, option C, unsatisfactory, and option D, political. The proper choice is C, unsatisfactory. Poems of both Thoreau's and Emerson's are unsatisfactory. Question number 15 is, H.D. Thoreau's prose style is, option A, satirical, option B, poetical, option C, conversational, and option D, rhetoric. The right answer is C, Thoreau's style is conversational. Question number 16 is, who said of Thoreau's poems that the thyme and marjoram are yet not honey? Option A, R.W. Emerson. Option B, Nathaniel Hawthorne. Option C, Edgar Allan Poe. And option D, Herman Melville. The correct answer is A, R.W. Emerson said these words. Question number 17 is, who spoke of Thoreau as picking up windfalls in Emerson's orchards? Option A, Nathaniel Hawthorne. Option B, J.R. Lowell. Option C, Herman Melville. And option D, Thomas Carlyle. The correct answer is B, J.R. Lowell, the literary critic, called Thoreau as picking up windfalls in Emerson's orchards. Question number 18 is, like Emerson, H.D. Thoreau preached the gospel of option A, joy, option B, pantheism, option C, kindness, and option D, independence. The right answer is D. The major concern of Emerson and Thoreau both was individual independence, self-reliance. Question number 19 is, who said about Emerson, mysticism for mysticism's sake? Option A, Edgar Allan Poe. Option B, H.D. Thoreau. Option C, Nathaniel Hawthorne. And option D, Herman Melville. The right choice is A. Edgar Allan Poe, who was literary opponent to Emerson, criticized his writings as mysticism for mysticism's sake. Question number 20 is, which of Emerson's work has this entry, little things are often filled with great beauty? Option A, nature. Option B, American Scholar Lecture. Option C, Harvard Divinity School Lecture. And option D, Journal for March 1852 Address. The correct answer is D, this entry, little things are often filled with great beauty, is from Journal for March 1852 Address. Question number 21 is, for Emerson, nature was a great source of option A, joy, option B, pain, option C, inspiration, and option D, ecstasy. The right answer is C, Emerson took a lot of inspiration from the nature. Question number 22 is, Emerson's central doctrine that submission to emotion is inadmissible to option A, I.A. Richards, option B, F.R. Lewis, option C, Wilson Knight, and option D, Ware Winters. The right choice is D, Weyerwinters opposed Emerson's idea of submission to emotions. Question number 23 is, according to John J. Chapman, Emerson represents a protest against the tyranny of option A, feudalism, option B, Christianity, option C, monarchy, and option D, democracy. The correct answer is D. Emerson represents a protest against the tyranny of democracy, according to John J. Chapman. Question number 24 is, Poe's Tales of Grotesque and Arabesque contains stories written between option A, 1830 to 1840, option B, 1835 to 1840, option C, 1840 to 1845, and option D, 1835 to 1845. The right answer is C. Tales of Grotesque and Arabesque contains stories written between 1840 to 1845. Question number 25 is, the Tales of Grotesque and Arabesque contains option A, 20 tales, option B, 40 tales, option C, 25 tales written up to 1840, and option D, 30 tales. The right choice is C. 25 tales of the Tales of Grotesque and Arabesque were written up to 1840. 8 more tales were added in second edition, which was published in 1841. Question number 26 is, who called Edgar Allan Poe a great lyric poet? Option A, W.B. Yeats, option B, Emerson, option C, Longfellow, and option D, Whitman. The right answer is C. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow called Edgar Allan Poe a great lyric poet. Question number 27 is, Emerson called Poe, option A, a jingle man, option B, a great lyrical poet, option C, a great American poet, and option D, none of these. The right choice is A, a jingle man. While appraising The Raven, Emerson said that he found nothing in that poem, The Raven, and he called Edgar Allan Poe as a jingle man. Question number 28 is, one of Poe's well-known stories is option A, The Ravens, option B, The Fall of the House of Ushers, option C, The Mask of Red Death, and option D, The Purloined Letter. The correct choice is B, The Fall of the House of Ushers, is the well-known stories by Allan Edgar Poe. Question number 29 is, The Purloined Letter reminds the reader of option A, mystery novel, option B, horror novel, option C, Sherlock Holmes, and option D, science fiction. The right choice is C, Sherlock Holmes. Why? Because it is a detective novel. The Purloined Letter is a detective novel, and the character of Sherlock Holmes was too much inspired by C. Dupin, which is the detective hero of that Purloined Letter. Question number 30 is, the Purloined Letter was written by option A, Poe, option B, Cooper, option C, Emerson, and option D, Hawthorne. The right choice is A, Edgar Allan Poe wrote the Purloined Letter. He created the first detective, fictional detective, C. Dupin. Question number 31 is, who called Poe 3/5 genius and 2/5 sheer fudge? Option A, Emerson, option B, Yeats, option C, Lowell, and option D, Cooper. The correct answer is C. James Russell Lowell called Poe as 3/5 genius and 2/5 sheer fudge. Question number 32 is, Edgar Allan Poe was born in option A, 1805, option B, 1809, option C, 1815, and option D, 1812. The right choice is B, Edgar Allan Poe was born in 1809. Question number 33 is, Henry James Cooper's The Last of the Mohicans presents a war between the native tribes such as option A, Magua, option B, Uncas, option C, Hurons, option D, Magua and Unquas. The correct choice is D, The Last of Mohicans present the war between Magua and the Uncas. Question number 34 is, in the last of the Mohicans, the native Indian Magua are called, option A, brave but unfriendly, option B, brave and fighting for territory, option C, treacherous for they refuse to accept white people as masters of the land, option D, strong and strong-willed, friendly with the French. The right answer is C. They were called treacherous for not accepting white people as masters of the land. Question number 35 is, the last of the Mohicans presents the fight of the early settlers with the option A, native Indians, option B, other settlers, option C, new settlers, and option D, French settlers. The correct answer is A. The last of the Mohicans presents the fight of the early settlers with the native Indians. Question number 36 is, the most famous leather stocking tales was option A, the Pathfinder, option B, the last of the Mohicans, option C, the Deer Slayer, and option D, Upside Down. The right answer is A. The Pathfinder was the most famous leather stocking tales. Question number 37 is, in the Ways of the Hour, Cooper wrote about option A, social reform, option B, social justice and its perversion, option C, revolution, and option D, freedom from British rule. The correct answer is B. In the Ways of the Hour, Cooper wrote about social justice and its perversion. Question number 38 is, who wrote The Spy and the Pirate? Option A, James Fenimore Cooper, option B, Washington Irving, option C, Ralph Waldo Emerson, and option D, Herman Melville. The correct choice is A. James Fenimore Cooper wrote these two novels, The Spy and the Pirate. Question number 39 is, what did Rip Van Winkle do when he found things had changed during the revolution? Option A, he went and lived with his married daughter and her family. Option B, he lived in a cottage which he built. Option C, he found new friends and lived with them. Option D, he went back to the hillside where he had spent 20 years in deep slumber. The right answer is A, he went and lived with the family of his daughter. Question number 40 is, how long did the Dutchman Rip Van Winkle sleep on hillside? Option A, 2 nights, option B, 4th night, option C, 1 year, and option D, 20 years. The right answer is D. Rip Van Winkle slept for 20 years. Question number 41 is, who wrote the unforgettable story entitled Rip Van Winkle? Option A, Peter Ewing, option B, James Fenimore Cooper, option C, Ralph Waldo Emerson, and option D, Washington Irving. The correct choice is D. Washington Irving wrote Rip Van Winkle. Question number 42 is, who wrote the sketchbook? Option A, Peter Ewing, option B, John Irving, option C, Pierre Ewing, and option D, Washington Irving. The correct answer is D. Washington Irving wrote the sketchbook of Geoffrey Crayon. Question number 43 is, in subject and method, Irving was option A, traditionalist and picturesque, option B, ancient, option C, pedantic, and option D, spirit of freedom. The right choice is A. Washington Irving was traditionalist and picturesque in the subjects and method of his writings. Question number 44 is, Irving's writings show the qualities of option A, graceful and humorous writing, option B, journalistic writing, option C, sensational writing, and option D, stylistic carefulness in language. The correct choice is A. Irving's writings show the qualities of gracefulness and humorous writing. Question number 45. The lifespan of Irving was option A, 1783 to 1859, option B, 1750 to 1839, option C, 1780 to 1865, and option D, 1805 to 1875. The correct answer is A. The lifespan of Washington Irving was 1783 to 1859. So this is it for today. We will continue to offer similar interesting multiple choice question series based on the different aspects of English literature while covering the whole course of UGC NET English Literature. Please remain connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.